Hello there. Welcome to this video guide. Let's quickly see all you need to know to start using Corel PaintShop Pro X9. Leave us comments below to improve your future guides for PaintShop Pro. When you open this software for the first time, a dialog box opens showing a list with useful tutorial videos about the main important features under the Learn tab. Check it out to get help on what you need most. Let's get to know the main important features to start with PaintShop. This software has all you need to manage and edit your photos completely by using three main workspaces, as you can see at the top. You first use the Manage workspace to collect and organize all your photos. Then you move to the Adjust workspace to quickly fix the photo's appearance or apply ready-made effects. If this is not sufficient, you can go to the Edit workspace in order to edit your photo pixel per pixel with professional tools. Let's see each of them. The Manage workspace is used to import, collect, and organize your photos. On top of the navigation palette on the left, you have two tabs. Collections lists all the different collections suggested by PaintShop. A collection is a group of photos that have a property in common, such as the people appearing inside, the exact date or the location the photo was taken, or its star rating. Whereas under the Computer tab, you can browse your own photos through your computer folders, your external hard drives, or any disk. All the photos inside a specific folder or a collection appear on the center. You can click on a photo to select it and preview it in the bottom left corner and check or edit all its related metadata through the info palette on the right, such as the device that took the photo, date, rating, tags, people, and places. If any of these palettes are missed because they are closed, you can open them again by going to View and then to Palettes. More at the bottom. You can fast rotate a selected picture by 90 degrees by using the Rotate Left and the Rotate Right buttons, or enlarge the picture thumbnails by using the zoom bar. To rename or delete a photo instead, just right-click on it. If you double-click on a picture, you will check it in full-screen mode. Below, a small interface lets you fix any rating, rotate the photo, or delete it by using the Bin button. Use the two arrows to shuffle, the zoom bar to zoom in and out, and click and drag on the picture to pan. Use the Escape key to exit from the full screen mode. In the top right corner, you can edit the way to preview your photos. This is the thumbnail mode, but you can also choose the preview mode or the map mode. The preview mode opens the organizer palette below, used to directly choose the photo you want to preview and to adjust. The map mode is used to check where the photo has been taken on the world map. Once you have organized your photos, you may need to adjust them to improve their colors and appearance. When you switch to the Adjust workspace, the whole interface changes. On the center, the selected photo is opened by using the Preview mode interface, as seen before. Use the Organizer palette below to choose the right photo. To check your photo carefully, you can zoom in and out by using your mouse wheel and pan by holding the spacebar key and clicking and dragging. On the left, you have the Adjust palette that lists all of the most quick and professional adjustments for your selected photo. On top, you have the color histogram that describes the intensity and distribution of the main colors on the selected photo. This is very useful to correct the photo appearance. Check out the video description for more information about the histogram. More below, the list of all the adjustment tools available. For example, choose Smart Photo Fix to adjust the main important properties of the photo appearance, such as brightness, to add or remove brightness, shadows to add or remove brightness on the darkest sides of the photo, highlights to regulate the brighter sides, and saturation to regulate the color strength or even reduce the photo to black and white. Each of these properties can be regulated in different ways. You can click and drag the marker on the bar, use your mouse wheel, click on the up and the down arrows, or type directly the value you need inside the box. You can click on Suggest Settings to set all these options automatically. More below. You have other advanced tools to improve your photo. Use White Balance. You can regulate the overall color of the photo by adding temperature and tint. Use Brightness, Contrast to adjust brightness and contrast on the overall photo as you like. Use Fill, Light, Clarity to adjust light and details. Use Vibrancy to enhance the color appearance and strength. You can also apply other advanced settings like Local Tone Mapping, High Pass Sharpen, and Digital Noise Removal. You can undo any adjustment or effect applied by using Ctrl and Z from your keyboard. You can also use the Undo and the Redo buttons on top of the preview to undo and redo all your actions. The Adjust palette also has five useful tools. The first one is the Crop tool, used to remove parts of the photo. When you enable it, a crop area appears on the photo. This represents the part of the picture you want to keep. Click and drag the area to move it, click and drag from its corner nodes to scale it, or click and drag from outside to rotate it. You can also click and drag on the overall photo to define your own personalized crop area. Click on Apply to crop. The Straighten tool is used to align your photo correctly according to the angle you give to a segment. Click and drag to move either of its two endpoints in order to define an angle. When you click on Apply on the left, the photo will be rotated in order to make the segment straight. The remaining three tools are used to adjust people's faces. Use the Red Eye tool to remove red eyes. Just make sure that the radius of the tool is sufficiently higher than the pupils by checking the settings on the left. Then just click on the eyes to correct them. The Makeover tool is used to adjust people's appearance by using several tools collected below. Blemish Fixer removes the imperfections of the skin. Toothbrush whitens teeth. Eye Drop whitens eyes. And Suntan darkens skin. Just click and brush on it. Thinify is used to make shapes thinner by clicking on the photo. Make sure not to use this tool too much or you will risk deforming the shapes. The last tool is called Clone Brush. This is used to copy parts of a photo to paste them on other parts and is very useful to hide sections or details. First of all, right-click on the photo to fix a circle with a cross on it. This indicates the point where you start copying. Then, if you click and drag, you will start pasting on the photo exactly what is under the circle. This brush follows the settings adjusted on the left, such as brush size and opacity. Use Ctrl and Z to undo if you make a mistake. You can also apply ready-made effects through the Instant Effects palette on the right. Choose the effect category and then browse the list. Click on an effect to check on top what your photo looks like. Then, double-click on the effect to apply it definitely. If you want to remove the effect, just use Ctrl and Z to undo. At the very bottom of the Adjust palette, you have two very useful buttons. Click on Revert to come back to the latest saved version of the photo, discarding all the adjustments and effects applied. Click on Show Original to see the original photo on the preview. In this way, you can check your photo comparing the original one and the one with all the applied modifications. To apply more advanced modifications on the photos, you need to switch to the Edit Workspace. From the Organizer palette, choose the photo by double-clicking on it. On the left, you have the Tools toolbar that collects all the tools available inside PaintShop, including the one seen in the Adjust workspace, such as the Crop tool, the Straighten tool, and the Red Eye tool. There are lots of other useful and powerful tools to edit your photos. For example, the Paintbrush tool brushes over your photo by using the color specified on the materials palette. If you click and drag, you will use the foreground color. If you right-click and drag, you will use the background color instead. On top, you can change all the settings related to such tools, such as the brush size, feather, and opacity. Other tools right below the paintbrush are used to apply adjustments in a more precise way with respect to the Adjust workspace. In fact, all the tools inside the Adjust workspace are always applied on the whole photo. In the Edit workspace, the adjustment tools can be applied locally without affecting the entire photo. You also have the Text tool, which adds text on your photos. Click on your photo and start typing. Use the options above to adjust the text font, style, and size. If you switch to the Pick tool, you can regulate the text box to move, scale, and rotate the text. You also have the Selection tools. These are used to select a part of your photo so that if you apply any tool on it, just the selected area will be affected. There are many other tools inside the Edit workspace. Check the Learning Center on the far right to get help at using a tool. Once you've finished your adjustments, save the photo by going to File and then to Save As. Choose the destination folder, the file format to use, and also the image quality. Consider that the higher the quality, the larger the file size, which you can check at the bottom. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our channel for more amazing and free video guides.